Hello there, welcome back once again to our channel. It's yours truly, Impressive IQ, and today I have something very special for you. If your woman does this, just advise yourself and leave her. Alright, so let's jump in. I know it can be a bit tricky, a bit difficult as a guy to know if a lady is truly into you or whether she's just stringing you along or dragging you along, giving you a tough time because she just doesn't want to hurt your feelings, or maybe she's enjoying something in the meantime and wants to see how long that will last. So as a guy in this situation, how would you quickly be in a position to know whether this lady is into you or she's just stringing you along for the ride so that you can make a decision to let her go or keep on keeping on with her? Stay tuned, I'm here to give you some quick tips on how to identify these. Number one, she takes her time and takes so long in getting back to you. You know, with how society is going, people can be really busy during the day, genuinely, and sometimes you may not be able to reach her at the time you want to speak to her. But then, if you have a lady who can go 24 hours without even reaching back to you or reaching out to you in the first place, and it comes back with excuses from her the following day, and these things are that consistent in your relationship, it's a very good indication that she's not really into you. Because trust me, no matter how busy people are, they tend to have some few minutes or hours of break time. And if this lady is really into you, when she has such a break time, or even at the end of the day lying in bed, she will definitely want to check on you, if you are that special person in her life, that is. And then that would be the signal to you that this person is looking at me the same way I'm looking at her. And the caveat here is that it shouldn't be going beyond 24 hours consistently before she even gets back to you or reaches out to you. Trust me, if the lady loves you or likes you, she's always eager to reach out to you. So if she has any little free time, it could even be just a text or maybe a call for 30 seconds or a minute. But if consistently you are the one chasing, calling, there is even no response, then my guy, please advise yourself. Tip number two, if she's consistently canceling plans on you, my guy, this is a red flag for you to advise yourself. So for example, you make plans, you put things together, and you ask her out, she agrees, and then it's getting to the date and she calls to postpone. Okay, once, well, no problem. Even twice, no problem. But if it becomes that consistent that anytime you're asking her out, she says, oh, okay, yeah, I agree, but then she comes back to tell you, oh, we have to postpone, or I can't make it, please take it from me. I know, just go ahead and find someone who would want to actually make time to hang out with you. Because the gig here is, we all love spending time with people that we love or have affection stores. So if you have this person who is always agreeing to go out with you, probably it's because she doesn't want to hurt your feelings to your face. But after that, she'll call you and tell you that you have to cancel. It means that she's not into you. Probably she's having difficulty telling you so. But please advise yourself, make it easy for both of you, and just move on. Tip number three, she calls you a friend. This one is, it's painful and serious. So you've been dating this lady for a while, you've been going out for a while, and all of a sudden she starts acting cold towards you. You go out with her, she meets some friends or colleagues of hers, and you believe you are in a relationship with her, or you actually know, both of you know you are dating, and she ends up introducing you as a friend. please believe that introduction. You are a friend. Just advise yourself and take your emotions and your heart to someone else who would respect it and also be proud to show you off to her world, because you are that special to her and she loves you genuinely. Number four, if she keeps telling you that she just wants to be friends with you and she's not ready for a relationship, you know, sometimes it could be interpreted by we guys as, oh, it's a challenge to see how much you love her and how you are dedicated to fighting to get her. Well, maybe in the short term we could look at it that way, but if it's consistently the same feedback to you over a period of time, my brother, please, it's not World Cup. Move on and find somebody who genuinely loves you as much as you love her. You know, love is so special when it's mutual. If it becomes one person chasing the love, over time you become exhausted and you lose your happiness. Number five, you are always the one to reach out in the relationship. No, this is a bit technical, but let's look at it this way. So it's a bit understandable that some ladies sometimes don't want to be initiating contact because they don't want to seem desperate in their relationship. Cool. But then, my brother, if you are consistently always the one initiating contact over a very long period of time, if you go back to your WhatsApp, you check everything, and in all your chats, you are the one initiating, oh, hi, how are you? I'm just thinking about you, I'm checking up on you, and she's just giving you straightforward answers, and she never reaches out to you of her own accord, out of her eagerness to check on you. She never calls you, initiates a call to you. It's rather about you call, she responds, and the conversation is just straightforward. You know, these are red signs to your face that the person is naturally not just into you. It might not even be deliberate, but it's just not there. So please, when you start seeing these things, you just have to advise yourself and you make it easy for both of you and you move on. Number six, read her body language. Now, sometimes you are even in a relationship with the girl already and you realize that anytime you are with her, she seems off. You bring up a conversation, she seems disinterested. Her body language is literally telling you that I want to be alone. You even try getting close to her and she sort of pushes you away or leans away, you know, makes certain comments. You just know, you can see it screaming at you that this person doesn't even want me here by her. You know, respect yourself, respect your dignity, respect your pride, and respect the fact that no matter how you look like, there's someone special out there for you who would love you and carry you as the most valuable thing in her world. And just end it and move on. Don't make it your life's work to get dragged on the floor because you are bent on having a relationship with this particular person who don't even really want to be with you, both physically, emotionally, and I don't even want to say spiritually, but you get it. My brother, just cut it and move on. Alright, so these are just the quick tips I wanted to share with you so that you can easily identify some of these things and move on with your life. You know, it's so sad when you see these things happening with some people. There are some really nice guys out there and sometimes they are being treated unfairly by some ladies who are wasting their time and are not even fed enough to them to let them know that it will not work. And some of these guys out there too, please, try and read the signals. At least I've given you some cues. And when you see that, just move on. Trust me, you'll find love and you'll be glad you did. Alright. So, as always, this is yours truly, Impressive IQ. Subscribe, like the video, add your comments in there. If there's something you think I left out, you can also decide to share your personal experiences. And you can share with other friends as well. These are life tips that go a long way to help all of us. And don't forget to turn on the notification button as well. As always, this is Impressive IQ, the mastermind of life.